on this season of 60 Second Stay. Let's go in and check it out.
Woo! Use the big knob.
All right. Oh my gosh, this is beautiful.
I never know there's so many birds one floor below being treated.
From a potato to a caboose, or a haunted mansion to a hobbit hole, we take you to the most unique Airbnbs in the country.
Wow, I feel like I need to touch it just so I can feel like I got really close to Jennifer Aniston.
So come on in, get comfy, and enjoy your stay on 60 Second Stay. To check out a spectacular Airbnb that is very appealing. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. Frank, thank you so much for meeting with me.
Well, welcome to Boise, Idaho and the Big Idaho Potato.
A potato Airbnb, it is unheard of. But of course, before it became a place that you could rent, it had a different purpose.
This potato was on tour for about 7 years. It's made out of concrete mainly and steel beam interior.
Okay, so I've never been inside a giant potato before, but there's a first for everything. Why don't we go inside and
okay,
check it out?
Let me show you.
This is so posh.
My daughter Christy is the one, this is her design. She loves designing things, and this potato was one of her dreams, and she is the creator.
She did such an incredible job. When you walk in here, you feel like you're in a chic hotel. Like, you don't feel like you're in a potato. When you first walk onto the property, you can't miss the bodyguard of the potato, Dolly.
She's a Jersey milk cow. She's almost as big of a roadside attraction as the potato. People stop by and feed her and pet her and all those kinds of things.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. Hi, I'm Charlie Neff, and today I'm in New Orleans, Louisiana to check out one of the world's most haunted Airbnbs. Join me on this special Halloween episode of 60 Second Stay. Adrian, so nice to meet you. Wait, you're not a ghost, right? You're a real person?
No, I'm for real. I'm a real person, but there are ghosts here.
I love that. Lots of roommates.
Lots of roommates, yes.
So you own the Parks Bowman Mansion here in the heart of the Garden District. There's been a lot of spooky experiences. What is the history behind this paranormal place?
It was built in 1884. It was owned for a long time by the Rod family. We suspect that the ghost here is the youngest daughter of the Rod family.
Let's go in and check it out, but with some caution.
Here we go, the spooky house.
Wow.
And welcome here.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Parks Bowman Mansion.
So there's a ghost here.
People see her all over the place, but mostly in the haunted bedroom, which is up on the third floor.
I think we need to go up there and feel the vibe.
Here's the haunted bedroom.
Oh my gosh, it's so spooky and I love the decor. So what are some of the interactions that guests have had with the young girl in here?
A lot of people have heard footsteps. Some people hear her singing a lullaby and some people have seen orbs floating around.
Have you had an interaction with her before?
A couple times I've heard her. I've heard the piano playing. I've heard a note or two struck when no one was in the room. One time as I was going down the stairs to the first floor landing, I saw out of the corner of my eye what looked like a woman wearing some sort of a long white pale garment going ahead of me going out towards the back door, and I thought it was a guest, and I said very brightly, good morning, and nobody there.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. And I'm in Sandy Valley, Nevada to take a peek at an Airbnb that'll make you feel like a true cowboy in the wild, wild west. So put on your boots and join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. Marilyn, so nice to meet you.
Charlie, we're so glad to have you here.
You have the covered wagon.
Right.
How did this come to be?
Oh, I just always wanted a covered wagon. The old Spanish trail came right through here. Actually, people that were migrating from New Mexico to California were camping all along that trail, so we know that their spirits are still here.
I can feel the spirits here.
You really feel you're going back in time to a slower, maybe more genuine time in life. defines what we do. Mm-hmm. Because it's the Old West. It's the symbol of the Old West. It has a lot of romance about it.
What is daily life like here?
I feed 100 mouths every day.
Oh my goodness.
Not personally, but I self-finance that. Chickens, pigs, goats.
How fun.
If you love animals, it's just heaven.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. Neff, and today I'm in Death Valley to check out a whimsical Airbnb that is truly the future of eco-art living. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. Carlo and Jack, this is the most artistic place I've ever seen. How did this come to be?
Well, about 25 years ago, I ended up buying the property. It was gonna be like an art collective. Wanted to try to like relieve my life in Vegas and like leave it behind a little bit.
Let's go inside. Yeah. I gotta see what this looks like.
Let's do it.
Oh my gosh, this is beautiful. I love how the sunlight just comes through the bottles and illuminates the room.
It took like 2 months of really serious love and work.
These bottles had another life before this.
When I was having these parties, especially in Vegas, I felt guilty about throwing bottles away. And I was like, oh, and I started keeping them. And my neighbors were like, what are you doing with that giant pile of bottles? I was like, no. And now we just recycle them fast and start using them for all kinds of different walls. So now we've got it in
around
the gardens.
What do you hope people take away when they leave here?
The spirit of the desert, which is like reusing things and being creative. It is such a strong, intense place, and it forces you to be creative mm-hmm. if you want to live out here and to reuse things.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. Here in beautiful San Diego, California, to check out a unique Airbnb that'll make you feel like you stepped into a Lord of the Rings movie. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. It's so exciting to be here.
So happy you could come down, Charlie.
At what point do you say, I want to build a Hobbit home?
I grew up with The Hobbit. I read the book as a kid. I knew I wanted a little guest house for friends and family to stay in. And there's nothing flat on this property as far as the terrain is, so I knew I'd probably dig into the hillside.
Let's go in and check it out.
Woo! Use the big knob.
All right.
The type of guests we get that come here, you know, it's not your normal place to come. So we get an eccentric group of people. I'm amazed at the people that are so enthralled by, you know, Tolkien's work and The Hobbit. Mm-hmm. And they come here and it's, you know, it's really over the top for them. They love it.
Wow. So beautiful.
I was really into weird plants. So I have a lot of aloes. These are types of aloes. To be a living roof, obviously there's not a lot of earth. So you have to be really careful what plants, you know? The roots can't go too deep. It has to be a plant that can dry out. So yeah, it's a pretty cool place to hang out.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. And I'm in the Mojave Desert to check out an Airbnb that'll make you want to toot your horn, literally. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. So nice to meet you.
Well, Charlie, I felt the same way about you.
Oh my goodness, this is an oasis in the middle of the desert.
It really is.
One of the many gems on the ranch is the Santa Fe Caboose.
Absolutely.
I feel like Route 66 has a lot of these like roadside attractions,
right,
and I feel like this ranch kind of falls under that.
It was one of the reasons I wanted to bring it here, because Route 66 is also really well known for trains, and we get so many train lovers that come out here.
This ranch is like a great place for animal lovers.
We rescue California desert tortoise because there's a lot of people who take them as pets and then don't want them. Then we have an emu that we rescued, and dogs and cats, and we rescue koi and all kinds of other things that people don't want anymore.
What do you think is the most special part about staying inside the train?
Well, it kind of depends on if you're 5, 9, or what age you are. The cupola. The cupola is the upper part there, and the conductor would be up there, and he would kind of keep an eye on the rest of the train. But kids love to go up there. They'll take their game boards up there and play games and look out the window and spy on people. It's got a lot of magic upstairs.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. Texas to get in the holiday spirit at an Airbnb inspired by the classic movie Home Alone. Join me on this special Christmas episode of 60 Second Stay, you filthy animals. Jeremy, thank you so much for letting me experience this magical place.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
What inspired you to bring Home Alone to your home?
I was listening to, you know, the soundtrack in July with my daughter, and it just hit me. Gosh, I love this movie. I love Christmas. Let's make an Airbnb like that house.
I gotta check it out, but I'm guessing Kevin probably has some booby traps set up, so I'll be a little wary. Yeah, we'll watch my step. Oh my gosh, I feel like I'm in the McAllister house right now. What were some of the details that were an absolute must when recreating it?
I had to have the Michael Jordan cutout on the train and the mannequins in the window. I had to have Buzz's room with all the shelves and all the little figurines. And this is one of my favorite rooms in the house. It's definitely one of the most fun photo ops to sit like you're Kevin about to eat your mac and cheese.
And then you got the pizza here too.
Oh yeah, oh, you have to have cheese pizza.
That's where you'll dive in,
for
right
sure.
Here. You can't have too much wine in this room because if you walk straight out of there, you're gonna run into one of Kevin's booby traps.
Oh yeah,
I can see from here. All
That's
the
true.
Little cars on the floor. That is hysterical.
Machines.
What kind of guests do you normally get here?
All kinds of people come here, but definitely mainly people who it's their favorite movie and they want to experience it with their kids, or maybe it's their kids' favorite movie.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. And today I'm in Boise, Idaho to visit an incredible Airbnb that is not only a place to stay for humans, but also for injured birds. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. Matey, thank you so much for meeting with me today.
Oh, and Charlie, thank you for picking us out to do your thing. We acquired this barn to use in 2000, and the whole downstairs was for birds and all the outbuildings, and we do about 3,000 birds a year. And then the upstairs was kind of an empty place, and we decided to turn it into an Airbnb in 2017.
So it's incredible what you guys do on the first floor, but I really want to see the, you know, top floor and see what that Airbnb looks like.
Oh, well, cool. It's
Should
very
we go
fun.
In? Oh, this is stunning.
That's the original roof from 1910. Up on this side and on the ceiling part.
It kind of makes you feel like you're in a human bird's nest.
Yeah, exactly. I call it the bird nest, and there's a few places are called bird this and bird that, and I thought it has to be called the bird nest.
It's crazy because it's so peaceful in here. You would never know that there's so many birds one floor below being treated.
Well, we have a lot of them. Would you like to go down and meet Jennifer, our director?
Absolutely.
Okay,
let's
go.
Jennifer, this is so awesome to be here with all these birds. What is daily life like here?
Daily life is very busy. We get lots of phone calls. We get intake after intake, injured birds, orphaned birds all day long. We're open from 8 in the morning till 8 p.m. and it does not stop. We are here caring for, feeding, rearing up until we can get them to a releasable state back out into the wild where they belong.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. And today I'm in Malibu, California to scope out a whimsical Airbnb that'll make you feel like you're in a fairy tale. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. Simone, thank you so much for meeting with me.
I love that you came here.
This castle is so enchanting. How does somebody end up with a castle in their backyard?
It was built by a stonemason. The water system was built in 1954. And then I want to say the fire was in 2007. Mm-hmm. And so shortly after that, they built the rest of it and made it a little castle.
You do have some chickens on the property.
Yeah.
That kind of have an interesting look to them. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the chickens and the roosters.
So the ones with the crazy hair are the Polish hens. Mm-hmm. And they walk around like, you know.
They have sass.
We have a lot of younger ones that just want the food. They're like dogs.
I feel like we need to get some shelter from the dragons in the area. So maybe we go inside and check it out. Oh, how majestic.
Everything is stone. So it keeps it cooler. in the summer. The person that built the castle originally, she put in all the glass windows. She really wanted it to be authentic.
Yeah. It's got like a medieval feel to it because of the stained glass windows.
And there's actually a lower level.
Where?
Would you like to see it?
Yes!
And here through the trap door.
Oh my goodness, a trap door!
Just be careful.
Alright. Ooh! So exciting!
And so this is all authentic inside of the original water cistern, and then that's where it starts building up.
Wow, so there would have been water in here at some point.
Yeah.
And now it's a cute little Airbnb.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. I'm Charlie Neff, and today I'm in Topanga, California to get my zen on at a rustic Airbnb that'll make you feel like you woke up in Japan. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay. David, super cool. You have a Japanese tea house in your backyard. Where did this come from and how did it get here?
Well, there was this amazing artist couple that owned this property for about 50 years. Somehow they found this, it was actually a kabuki stage for performances.
Well, I want to go inside and check it out.
Sure,
let's go see.
Oh, how cool! I love the wood beams on the top.
Yes, that's part of the original Japanese architecture.
So I know there's some kind of celebrity fun fact about this room in particular.
About a year after we bought the property, we had an amazing carpenter here who happened to be doing a $28 million renovation on Jennifer Aniston's house.
Oh my goodness!
Had, of course, very long pieces, and then they would cut them in order to fit them into her house. And so, with this giant pile of scraps. So he brought it all over here, and then we started using it.
Wow, I feel like I need to touch it, just so I can feel like I got really close to Jennifer Aniston at one point. All right, mission accomplished. Oh my gosh, how cool! Woo!
We've had so many people let us know that they arrive here and they're like, oh my god, what is this place? We're in LA, but it feels like you're 1,000 miles from any city.
You feel like you went to Japan without
exactly.
a flight.
Yeah, we really try to, you know, nurture that quality and give people a beautiful experience here when they come.
I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay. I'll catch you next time. I hope you enjoyed your stay on this episode of 60 Second Stay.
You want me to just talk to you?
Yeah. Yeah, you don't have to look at the camera.
Yeah. Might have to watch or listen for the motorcycles and the cars too.
True.
Voila!
Really good.
Jamie, you're so cute!
It's good, really good.
Really good.
It does, it's great. I like
you're
this.
You're such a valley boy now.
Really good.
Join me on this special Christmas episode of 60 Second Stay. You filthy animals.
That was good. Three takes.
Who am I? Charlie Neff. Hi, I'm Charlie Neff, and today I'm in Boise, Idaho. Join me on this episode of 60 Second Stay.
I cannot.
This you hat.
I cannot. No. You want me to hop over? Yeah.
Oh God, here we go. I wish I had that on video.
Hi, I'm Charlie Neff, and we're at a big barn today with all these rescue birds.
Join me on this special episode. Sorry, almost. I didn't care for that one as much. That was a little cheesy. Is that too short, cheesy?
That's good. No,
Jamie's
it's good.
Like,
no, it's
this
good.
Terrible.
Yes, and lots of birds. What am I telling you again? What I'm supposed to say? I'm sorry. Now,
it's okay.
Now don't talk about me when I'm gone.
No, we love you.
You're so cute. You want to pull one out, Jamie?
Oh, how cute!
I can't.
Hi, I'm Charlie Neff. Testing.